Hi everybody, I'm Mike Devaney with the St. Genevieve Art Guild, and this is longtime Art Guild member and founder of the St. Genevieve Art Guild, a co-founder with others, Betty Garrity. Hi Betty.
Hi.
And we're sitting in Betty's beautiful home full of antiques and paintings you can see behind us. And I've spent several hours here talking to Betty over the past few months getting ready for your big art exhibit. And you may have seen this poster. This is
my daughter.
That's a painting Betty did of her daughter, and we used it for the poster for our Promenade d'Art. And we asked Betty Garrity if she would like to be our honored artist this year, and she said yes. What made you say yes? I mean, I know that for a long time you were kind of not wanting to do it. What happened?
I don't know. Oh, I'm just. Here I am.
Well, we are glad. And the exhibit opens on Friday, October the 9th, Friday night at 6 p.m. From 6 to 8 p.m. we'll have a reception. And Betty will be there unless she's watching the Cardinals game. And you're a big Cardinals fan, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah. So how are we doing this year?
Wonderful.
Yeah? We're going to make the playoffs?
Yeah.
Did we yet?
I don't know.
But I don't know either. But they were close to making the playoffs.
Yeah, very.
Another game or two. Yeah. So, and then her exhibit will continue on Saturday and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Mammy Shaw House in St. Genevieve at the corner of Merchant and 2nd Street. By the way, the Mammy Shaw House has a big history in St. Genevieve, doesn't it,
yes.
For art?
Yes. Starting with Matthew Ziegler.
Yeah.
He lived there. Yeah.
And Matthew was one of the.
Already painted there.
Colony members from the 1930s.
I think.
Mm-hmm. And that house also was in his family for a long time,
yes.
Wasn't it?
Yes.
And they rented it to the art colony in the 1930s. And Matthew was the only local artist in that colony.
And I think he was. Ground it and getting the artists all settled in here and comfortable. Yeah.
Most of them are from St. Louis.
Yes.
Well, you've had some art in St. Louis before, haven't you?
Very little.
There was an Art Mart exhibit and some other exhibits. I didn't bring my notes, but I know that you've exhibited in St. Louis before.
Mm-hmm. With Charles Reinhart.
Charles Reinhart.
Yeah.
Now, Charles Reinhart is a St. Genevieve artist who is kind of significant to you.
Yeah.
You told me a story one time about how you started painting.
We started with Charles Reinhart. We were his first group from Farmington. And we went on from there, and he was our first teacher. And so it was just mutual.
Who was in that class? Do you remember anyone in that? Was Becky,
Becky
Landrum in that class?
Becky. Mm-hmm. Betty Merriman, who's now passed.
Mm-hmm.
And, so many others, and it's been so long ago.
Yeah, so
great.
You were in his first class.
Yes.
In Farmington,
yes.
And he was your first teacher.
Right, correct.
So
we were deciding in our group in Farmington, did we want to go on with art and become better and more trained, and who did we want? And I don't know if I should say it, but we were debating between Charles and Dimitri.
Uh-huh.
And we decided on Charles.
Uh-huh. So Charles Reinhart was your first art teacher, and you told me it's a kind of a humorous story about your first class when you were.
Oh, we all sat in a room, and he came in, and here we are, his first class. And we were all just so busy painting away with oil paints and what have you of a still life. And he walked around the room and he said, stop. Now, stop. Let's all put our paints away and let's go for a walk. Get your sketchbook. We all needed to take drawing, sketching first.
Ah.
We thought we were really pretty good, you know.
Yeah. So we have a visitor. Who's this?
This is about a 23-year-old cat that lived in this yard half of her life, and then she was attacked by a chipmunk And the vet said she has to come in the house.
So
here she is.
So this is the only cat I know that lost to a chipmunk.
She sure did.
She lost to a chipmunk. Well.
And the vet said, that won't work.
Does she sit?
Does she sit?
Or does she just stand there?
She just does whatever she pleases.
Because she's 20-something years old. And what's her name?
Her name is Coco.
Coco.
And we shared her,
yeah.
Irene Grass and I. Irene lived next door. We both took care of her out in the yard, and she did very well out there until the chipmunk got her. Gosh, how embarrassing.
Well, she doesn't seem to be, she seems to be happy with it, that she's
still
alive.
Well, I guess.
Yes.
She's happy to be inside.
Yeah.
We didn't know quite what we were going to do with an outside cat inside, but
yeah.
It worked out.
And you, that's not your only pet.
No.
No, you have some others
two.
Hanging around.
Binky, the fat one.
Binky.
He's very plump.
Uh-huh.
And he has a fan club.
Binky has a fan club?
Yes. People actually come to see him.
No.
I
don't even have a fan club.
Well, I don't either, but he sure does.
And then your other...
And then we have Sugar.
Sugar. Have you always had
cat.
Always had pets?
Yeah.
Have you painted pets?
No, never.
No. What did you paint? What were some of the subjects that you painted?
Early on.
Any time.
Landscape and.
Yeah.
Mostly landscape.
Landscapes.
I prefer that. Plein air.
And I've seen some flowers. We've got a few examples of your work. This one.
That's kind of imaginary, out of my head.
Mm-hmm. It looks like a floral. Is it floral?
Yeah.
And it's watercolor.
Oh, sure.
And ink.
And ink, brown ink.
Very colorful.
Thank you, I think.
And I'm just going to show a few of these pieces. These pieces will be framed and hanging in this show. And you'll be able to see them up close. And
mm-hmm.
Is this from your personal collection, your own collection of your own work?
Yeah.
Well, now some of the pieces we're collecting from all over the place to put in
yes.
the show.
Yes.
But these just came back from the matters and framers. And this is another pen and ink watercolor
mm-hmm.
still life,
yeah.
floral.
No, that's black ink.
Black ink. And I love the loose style you have with your watercolor. Just so loose, and then you go in, and I've done this too with a loose watercolor just to make it look more like something. Add the ink strokes.
Really?
Yeah, that kind of, to me, I need a little more definition before I can say it's finished.
Yeah.
But other artists, they can leave the loose watercolor there and just let it go.
Doesn't matter, then.
No. And I think you've done that over here. Watch
I that. Like to do that.
Yeah, look at this. This is that no ink.
Oh, yeah.
And
very loose,
and it looks like a landscape with a house
mm-hmm.
and some trees with different techniques of watercolor that you learn over the years, how to let wet on wet and let things bleed. And
yes.
So you didn't start in watercolor, though, did you? Did you start painting in watercolor, or was it more oil paints, or... Charles painted in oils mostly, didn't he?
Yeah, you're right. I think we painted in oils,
mm-hmm.
which I think was more cumbersome and more difficult
mm-hmm.
than watercolor, but a lot of people don't like to try on watercolor very much.
Well, I've worked in both. I worked in watercolor to start and then oil.
Uh-huh.
And I just finished a watercolor, and I was noticing how easy it is to clean your brushes and to, to clean up and start again.
Odor-free.
Yeah, I mean, everything is easier to use that way with the materials.
Mm-hmm.
But you get two different effects, though,
yes,
from watercolor and oil.
And I think in oil, it's more forgiving. You can work over it, I don't know, it's whatever you think it is.
Uh-huh. And it's got some ink in it, not much, but just enough to show like a little skyline up in here.
And I think I did it on wet paper.
Yeah, it looks like a very wet on wet technique, but they're very beautiful.
Well, thank you, and it has ink, black ink.
And this is typical of what people would know as your artwork, more watercolor and pen and ink pieces.
Yeah.
So other than Charles Reinhardt, did you take other training?
Oh, I know I took other classes, but don't put me on the spot. I can't remember.
Okay.
Workshops.
Yeah. Things like that.
Yeah.
Over the years.
Yeah.
Couple a year maybe, or?
Maybe once a year.
Once a year?
Something like that. Mm-hmm.
Did you ever teach?
No.
No?
Gosh, no.
Because you were busy doing other things. What was some of the other things you did? You had a store.
Yeah, we had an antiques and art gallery.
Right here in this building.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then we moved here eventually.
Mm-hmm.
I had trouble with my knees, and we moved from our two-story house on St. Mary's Road. And we decided we had the shop, so why not move here, the building.
Oh, okay. So you were using it as a shop before you moved here.
And an art gallery, yeah.
And speaking of art galleries, were there other art galleries in town at the time? Do you remember?
Not sure. Mm-hmm. That's been a long time.
Did Judy Sexhauer have hers open yet?
No.
No?
She probably framed, but...
Yeah. You didn't frame.
Oh, no.
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 So how did that go? You had it open for several years then?
It seems like a long time.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Can you, you were instrumental in St. Genevieve in so many ways, one and with the arts, and one was co-founding the St. Genevieve Art Guild. I know. It's
Jane Nager.
Jane Nager.
Mm-hmm. And you have to help me.
Well, Anna would know better than I
about
those names.
She came very close to the beginning if she was not in the beginning.
Anna Kirshner.
Kirshner.
Uh-huh. And we're talking the early 80s, I think.
No, very, very long time ago.
Uh-huh.
And we had meetings here and there and up at the school, I remember. And we finally got quite a crowd of people to join. And held on to a good group.
Uh-huh.
And it went from there. And I think it's been a good, solid group of people.
Mm-hmm. Well, the 80s, the early 80s is only 40 years after the colony was here. So it's like a generation after the colony.
I didn't realize that.
And that's not very long, if you think about it.
Uh-uh.
And there were other art things going on from the 1940s through the 80s. I mean, the 1980 wasn't the start of a new group of artists, really. It was artists had been here all that time.
And people that knew each other from generation to generation.
Uh-huh. Yes, I call St. Genevieve fertile ground for art.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter. You can plant seeds here and they just grow.
Right. I remember when we came over with the group from Farmington, a little girl would kind of hang over us and watch us, and that turned out to be Jane Nager.
Oh.
She grew up.
She grew up
she's
around.
She's a painter.
Yes, she is, and she's taught art in schools
here. Right.
And she's still painting.
Uh-huh.
She's experimenting and doing different things
uh-huh.
all the time.
Uh-huh.
So you've known her for...
Ever.
Yeah.
Since she was a little girl.
Well, the St. Genevieve Art Guild several years ago made you an honorary member, which means you never have to pay dues again.
Oh.
And you could come anytime you want
to. Oh, thank you.
And you could even take over the meeting if you wanted to.
No, thank you.
Well, I'm the president. I give her permission. She can
come in
and take over the meeting and anytime she wants to, you're welcome.
He's doing a fine job.
Well, I'm standing on some shoulders here. I mean, I think that John James Audubon was here in St. Genevieve in the early 1800s or late 1700s.
Yeah.
and he did some work here. There's not much history of art, but you know, the Catholic Church there was art here. The Catholic Church has some paintings that were probably brought in from Europe.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't have a lot of record until the 1930s when the art colony came here. And then they lived here for 10 years.
Yes.
Lived and worked here for 10 full years.
Here in St. Mary's.
Yes. Yes. One of the artists lived in St. Mary's with
and
his
Art
wife.
Art Peters.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So I think all of the work that they did for 10 years, living here, meeting with the people, doing art lessons, and Thomas Hart Benton was a teacher in the school for 2 years.
Correct.
Joe Jones and other people.
Uh-huh.
Now,
I think they taught a lot at Matthews in that courtyard.
Uh-huh. Yeah, at the Mammy Shaw House.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's where we're going to have our reception Friday
wonderful.
Night. Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Great history there. Now, getting back to Matt Ziegler and the colony, you know, we've presented you as a living link to our art colony because you did know Matthew Ziegler.
Mm-hmm.
He
was
very
a good friend. When we first came over from Farmington, and I was living there with my husband, and the group of us would come over, and we were hungry for art. And we'd go to Matthew's and into the courtyard, and there'd be a door open, and it said on a sign nailed to the door, "Dogs welcome." And that was Matthew.
Uh-huh.
I remember having to ride with him to Chester every evening, sometimes Dolly and sometimes the both of us, and feeding a mother dog because he was convinced she was homeless and needed to be fed every day.
He would drive to Chester to feed her?
Yes, and she kind of lived on the side of the road, or she knew to come there and get food from him too. That's what I think. She had puppies.
Wow, what a story. Now, Dolly, you mentioned Dolly. Dolly is Matthew Ziegler's niece.
Niece, right.
Dolly Surkamp.
Right.
Catherine Marie. I think it was Catherine her name was. But everyone called her Dolly because she made dolls.
Right.
Yeah.
She did.
Beautiful
she
dolls.
Made lovely dolls.
Yeah. And we showed her dolls recently.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It was a good show.
I think it was our last promenade we showed her her work.
Well, the arts were here from, as far as we know, the 30s. And it was just, we were an enthusiastic group, and it just seemed natural to come over and keep on painting. And Charles was our first teacher and our main one.
And he was from here, Charles Reinhardt.
Yes, uh-huh. His family lived here.
And Charles painted here for a long time, and then he, I think he remarried and moved away, right?
Yeah, he married La Vida.
Mm-hmm.
And where did they? I can't remember the name of the town, but it's a small town in Missouri.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and he's doing very well with his painting reproductions and things like that I've heard.
Mm-hmm, I have too.
Mm-hmm. Matthew, we were talking about Matthew and feeding the dogs, and you riding to Chester with Dolly. And
well, Matthew was kind of instrumental in coaxing and keeping those artists, those 30s artists down here, I think.
Mm-hmm.
He made them welcome, and he found them places to live while they were down here, and he was instrumental in all of that.
Well, there was a core group that lived here, but there was a lot of visiting artists that came in.
Absolutely.
That came in and took lessons.
Some were prominent already, like Thomas Hart Benton.
Mm-hmm.
And who else?
Martiel.
Martiel.
Uh-huh.
And her mother, Amy Schweig.
Mm-hmm. Sister Cassiana.
Yes, very.
Mm-hmm. Joe Vorst.
Well, you can remember better than I.
Bernard Peters.
You're just a kid.
Huh? Well, I've read the book about three times. There are a couple of books available on the St. Genevieve Art Colony. And, you know, one of these days we may get a Thomas Hart Benton show here.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, so it'll be...
We might get help from St. Louis with that.
Yeah.
I think he was up there quite a bit.
Well, that would put, since I've been here the last 3 years, we've done Martille.
Mm-hmm.
And then we've done Roscoe Misselhorn.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to talk about him for just a minute. Your face just lit up. He was a good friend of yours too, wasn't he?
Yeah, Jim Baker and Bud, my husband, and I went every week to Chester. And he'd be waiting in Sparta. We'd meet at Chester or we'd go on to Sparta. And he'd say, Ruth, if they don't get over here pretty soon, all the good pieces of chicken are going to be gone.
Where would they be?
So impatient.
Where would they go?
Well,
would he eat them?
Sure.
Oh. So.
Yeah, he was a charming man. Talented man.
What made you guys late?
We weren't late. He was anxious.
Oh, okay.
That was his personality.
So, but he used to come here a lot.
Roscoe
Misselhorn.
Yeah.
Every week?
At least every week. And he'd be sitting out in front sketching from his car. And,
he sketched St. Genevieve so much. His sketches are used to historically date things.
Yes.
Because
they're accurate.
They're accurate.
If there was a trash can in the front yard when he did the house, it was in the front yard when when the sketch was finished.
So he would visit with you?
Yeah,
and eat here.
Jim,
And Jim.
Yeah.
Now, Jim Baker, he is the in charge of the Mammy Shaw House because it's a state historic site, part of the Felix Valley property and the Shaw House. And in fact, that's where his office is, in that beautiful old French colonial building.
Right.
Corner of Second and Market, where your reception is going to be on Friday, October the 9th.
Yeah.
And we want everybody who sees this video to feel free to come to that reception and meet Betty and tell her how well she did today on this taping.
Oh my goodness. Don't say that.
Well, then they can tell me how well I've done.
Right.
Okay.
Correct.
Because I need it. Anyways, getting back to Roscoe Misselhorn, do you remember how you met him?
Oh, he was over here a lot.
Yeah.
And Roscoe was a fine professional pencil sketch artist. And he just thought everybody else was better at art than he was. He was the most humble man. He was delightful.
Mm-hmm.
He was such a character. And I don't know, we just fell in with each other, and Bud and I, and Jim Baker, and Roscoe, and Ruth, his lovely little wife.
Mm-hmm.
He was almost 7 foot tall, and she must have been five.
Oh. Yeah, he painted, I mean, he did mostly black and white pencil sketches, but we've seen some of his paintings.
Well, I know I have some, but that wasn't his forte.
Yeah, we had a show. One of our promenades was Roscoe Misselhorn, but we wanted to capture a part of him that people didn't see very often, and so we collected his colored works. And so did Roscoe Misselhorn and Matthew Ziegler know each other?
Oh, of course, they were friends
from
the beginning. That's how we met Roscoe, I think.
Through Matthew?
Yeah.
Matthew Ziegler, did you ever meet his aunt, Sister Cassiana?
No, I never did.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember meeting any of the other colony members?
Mm-hmm.
Like Martille?
No.
Mm-hmm. I know she came to town.
She came to town one time, yeah.
And I think you did meet her at that point.
Yeah, at that briefly, but that's the only one in that group.
Mm-hmm. 'Cause they were pretty on in years at that point, weren't they?
Yeah.
In the 80s, yeah. So, let's see, are there, what about Leon Bosler? Do you know Leon very well?
I bought one of his paintings at his last show. I think he's wonderful.
Ah, I see it right there.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Oh, that was at his last show?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. And
at Judy's Gallery?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you picked a nice one.
I think so.
So he lives in Idaho now, I think, or North Dakota. something like
Montana.
That. Way out west.
Yeah, Montana.
We do agree on it. It's out west.
Yeah.
But he comes back often, once a month or so.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, when we all were kind of following Charles, he put a show together. That's one of his little ones on top there.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they gave me that for licking all the stamps and sending all the mail out. And they gave me that lovely picture.
Yeah, it is beautiful.
Yeah.
It's a mountain scene with some sunlight coming through. And
yeah.
So Al Agnew, is Al a person you know too?
I know him, but mm-hmm. not as well as I would know them.
Mm-hmm. But he's another artist from St. Genevieve that's been
artist.
Very successful.
I think we went out to Wyoming and, where's that wonderful place that's full of art?
Santa Fe?
No.
In Wyoming? I'm not sure. I have no idea.
Oh, you would if I told you, if I could think of it. Anyway, that's what we saw when we walked into this first gallery. It was just all galleries and there's Al Agnew.
In Wyoming.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Well, he's a wildlife painter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A very good one.
Yeah. He's gotten a lot of honors for that.
Yeah, we can be proud of him.
Now, more recently, someone has moved into town, a young lady named Allie Cavanaugh.
Yeah.
You've met Allie.
Yeah, I've met her.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And you've seen her work.
She's great.
She can sure paint, can't
yeah,
she?
Yeah, she can.
She paints watercolor on clay board, and it resembles a fresco.
Right.
But it uses a very teeny brush. And I kind of was
like
talking to
you. Like a one-hair brush.
Yeah, yeah, like a one-hair brush. And I was talking to you earlier about some of your pen and ink. There's a painting that we'll see in the show. It was just brought in, but it's in the other room. It's very large and full of pen and ink strokes that are a quarter of an inch or an eighth of an inch or even smaller. Very tedious work,
yeah.
But you could
I
tell you didn't spend
that.
A lot. I mean, you could see the action in it. And, but you love painting with that. Brown? You used a
brown ink? Yeah.
So are you painting now? Are you doing any painting now?
No, not right now.
No?
No.
Do you remember the last time you painted?
No.
A couple years ago?
No.
Are you not sure?
I'm not sure.
Okay. Well, and do you plan to paint again? Are you feeling like painting or are you pretty much done painting or don't you know?
I can't answer that. I don't really know. I can't know.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we hope that you might produce some more work, but if you don't, you have left behind certainly a bunch of great artworks.
Oh, thank you, sir.
So you could be officially retired, I guess. Never have to paint again.
Oh.
So, but you never know when it comes to
art.
People just...
Well, I'm going to a class with a group from here.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you are painting then.
Yeah.
You're painting now?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So, okay, tell
them. They're painting... Well,
where are you going?
We're going to Jefferson Memorial, I guess. Is it?
Mineral Area College?
Yeah, the college. It's very nice.
And with Jim Wilson?
Jim Wilson. He's a wonderful teacher and guide.
Yeah.
And we're senior scholars, I think, we're called. And he has a regular class, too. And
there's a group of you.
So we have to behave because they're expected to, and they do. And,
well, he's in his 50s, isn't he? Wouldn't you say he's in his 50s?
Yeah,
he's painted all his life. He's a very accomplished painter, a very skilled painter.
Yes.
And he's the resident artist in residence at Mineral Area College.
Yeah.
Jim Wilson. He's exhibited here in St. Genevieve before.
Yeah.
And anyway, so Jim has a class that you go a couple times a week?
Mm-hmm. Tuesday and Thursday.
Do you all ride over together?
Mary Pura? Mary Pura. Fills the van.
Dr. Hoy.
Oh, I didn't know if you wanted me to say.
And Anita?
Anita.
Also?
Myself.
And you?
And?
I know I've been invited, but how would I fit with all of you guys? Is there a big school bus that goes over there?
We're all not. Fat.
I I didn't say
that's
that.
That's just what he's
no.
just thinking that. And
I can't believe you said that.
You said it.
No,
you
I was just.
It.
I was just thinking of a 4-seater car. How would I fit?
Fine. There could be 3 in the back seat.
One thing that I don't qualify. I'm not yet a senior.
No, you're not old enough.
But it won't be very long, will it?
Well, I don't know.
Well, people can see the gray and
oh.
everything else that's happening to
you
me.
You can be gray at 16.
We all get older. Okay, I wish we could go back in time, but we can't.
No.
So we have to enjoy what we're doing
right.
today, and
yes.
I think that's what you do.
I hope so.
It is. I mean, I have yet to be visiting with you when you've been, you know.
What?
Anything but cheerful.
Thank you.
Even if you don't feel like it.
Oh, I always feel cheerful.
Yeah, well, good. And you have a beautiful home here. It's a nice sunny day. And you have a great art exhibit coming up now, and we're doing it for you because we want to.
I thank you.
And there
I
was,
appreciate it.
Speaking of humble, I think that you said you didn't want to do it at one point because you didn't think that your work was...
Well, I still don't think it's as good as everyone else's work.
Everyone else's?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we do.
Well, thank you.
And we're glad that you agreed to. I remember talking to you and Judy's one day and asking you if you had decided to do the show yet. Do you remember that conversation?
I remember, but I don't remember what I said.
I said, are you going to do the show? And you said, well, I don't know. And I said, well, you know we're going to do the show one year with you or without you. Would you like to be a part of it?
Wasn't that nice?
Because we were going to do her work. We think it's good enough. And that's the whole point I'm trying to make, is you didn't, but we do. And we're so glad to have you, Betty Garrity.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks for being on.
It's a pleasure to be with you all.
Don't forget to come make it a plan to meet Betty on Friday, October the 9th at the Mammy Shaw House in St. Genevieve, the corner of Merchant and 2nd Street. From 6 to 8 p.m. we'll have a reception with refreshments and music and Betty and her work. And then the exhibit will continue. If you can't make it Friday night, the exhibit will continue Saturday and Sunday. But we can't promise that you'll see Betty on Saturday or Sunday. You might pop in and you might not.
No,
but
no.
So please come if you want to talk to her Friday night, October the 9th, at the Promenade d'Arts exhibit honoring Betty Garrity from St. Genevieve. And I guess that's it.